guys, welcome to another episode of Matters of the Heart with Honey Bunch. I'm really excited to be doing this video because, like, all through the holiday, all through the Easter break, I was just recapping a lot of stuff. And by the way, I bumped into a friend of mine, a childhood friend of mine, Aisha Sunny. I swear down, I was so excited when I bumped into you, and trust me, it was something I never imagined was ever going to happen. But it did. I just bumped into her. Like, this life is so small. Like, the world is so small, rather. And you just don't know who you're going to bump into. I bumped into Aisha. Like, we screamed like mad people because we never thought ever that we were going to bump into each other. But then, Aisha, you know I love you. You know I got your back all the time. I told you I was going to talk about this on my vlog. And this is me keeping my word. I miss you, girl. I know, right? Like, it's crazy. By the way, you look so pretty. Maybe I didn't say that to you that day. Okay, enough of that. That's not why I'm here. I'm here because I was thinking about a lot of stuff. I was thinking about my upbringing. You know, I was thinking about the way my parents raised me. And I'm just going to tell you a little story about my upbringing. I come from that home where everything had to do with division of labor. Like, you can imagine that, right? My mom will literally tell you, you do this in the morning, my sister would do this in the afternoon. Like, we ate 3 times a day, so I do the morning dishes, my sister does the afternoon dishes, my brother does the night dishes. Like, it was so bad that we lay the bed, you know, we take turns to lay the bed. My mom was so organized. I don't want to say my mom was strict, but at some point I felt my mom was so strict. I felt my mom was like a wicked person, you know, because she was just really mean. She tells you to do something and you don't do it, man, you're going to get your ass whipped. And it was just really sad because, you know, every time I, you know, see my friends and then the way they talk about their parents and then the way they are free to go out and then come back every other time they like, I'm like, what's my mom different? What's my dad different? You know, why do they have to give us curfew? You know, like, you're going out and you're sure that by 5 you're home. If not, you're dead. When I say you're dead, you're dead. I kind of just wonder how I don't have scars on my body because my mom beat the hell out of me. Like, sometimes I can't even believe that woman right now. My mom beat the hell out of me. I remember this one particular time. I hated my mom. Mom, I'm sorry, but then I really hated her at that point. Okay, let me tell you what happened. Let me just give you a quick story. My mom was going out. She had some kind of meeting and she was going out. And then we had this girl who was staying with us then, like, more likely cousin of my mom's, but she was older than I was, you know. And my mom told her that we all had to fetch water back to division of labor again. God, you know. So she said that we should fetch water, and then I had a drum to fill up. Can you imagine? A drum, not even a bucket, a drum. And then the other girl had a drum to fill up. And I just got back from school and she told me we had to fetch water, and I'm like, okay, just give me some time, I need to sleep, like, I'm really tired. Probably when I wake up, you know, I'll fetch mine. Just, you can fetch yours. And then I slept off. Like, I slept, I totally forgot I was supposed to fetch water, and my mom got back. Of course, you know what's going to come next, right? She found the girl fetching water, and apparently she asked the girl, where's Betha? And then that one said she's sleeping. Like, the girl could never find something nicer to say. Like, okay, she said she'll fetch her water later, but she just wanted to rest for a while, or she has a headache, or just come up with some sort of story for my mom. But no, instead she told my mom that I was sleeping. And my mom came inside. Of course I was sleeping, so I didn't even know. And then I turned and turned and turned, like, I was enjoying my sleep. And I kept turning and kept turning and kept turning until I turned and I just saw my mom looking at me. Like, she sat down, she was there with a cane just waiting for me to wake up. Like, really, couldn't she have just woken me up? Or couldn't she have just, you know, called me or said something. But no, she waited for me to wake up. And immediately I woke up. Oh my God. The cane she was holding broke on my body. I know a lot of people would not believe this, but God, I had too many scars while growing up. But I thank God for the kind of skin I have. Like, you know, you hardly even know that I was flogged. You know, and some people don't even believe that. I used to do a lot of dishes. I used to wash a lot of clothes. My mom would never allow the girl wash her clothes. You have to wash your clothes. I had to wash my siblings. I had to wash their clothes. Like, I had to do most of the work in the house. And it was just really annoying. And then that particular day, my mom whipped me with that cane and it broke on my body. I just hated my mom. At some point, I felt she wasn't my mom. Like, really? Who would beat a child like that? I mean, what have I even done wrong? I haven't even said I won't fetch the water. So yes, I'm from that home where there was a lot of discipline. I don't want to talk about my dad, because my dad, that's a story for another day. My dad one time threw a knife at me. You know, he was that angry, and then he threw a knife at me, and of course he knew I was going to miss the shot, but then he still threw it, you know. I mean, and then these days when I just look at my parents, I'm saying something and then they're just looking at me and then just smiling. I'm like, okay, these people are really getting old. Like, because if it was back in the days, either I get a slap or I'm flogged, you know. Either ways, you know. But over time, I just realized that, look, all of these things were just to make me a better person. Like, right now, I'm not even with my parents, but every time I'm doing something wrong, I just feel, oh, my mom is going to flog me, you know, at my age. It sounds stupid, right? But truth is, African parents have a unique style of treating their kids. You know, the way the Westerners train their kids are not the same way African parents train their kids. My mom can never scold my cousins abroad, you know, but she scolds us like, who cares? But the truth is, those things they talk about are real. Those things they complain about, it's not like, of course, they're just doing their part. That's how they know how, that's how they know best. That's how they were brought up. So they feel that that's the best way to do that. Maybe I'm not going to be, you know, that kind of parent. Maybe not. Maybe not. I could be worse. I know I'm full of drama, but I could be worse. And I could be better. I hope I'm better at raising my kids. I really don't think I want to be that mom who would scream at her child and, you know, beat her at every single opportunity I get. No. And it's not like my mom used to beat me all the time. But then she says some things to you that you would have just preferred she beats you. I don't know if that's ever happened to you. Like, you do something bad and then you're just wishing that your parents will beat you instead of talking. But those times, my mom will never beat you. She will talk to the point where you begin to have a headache and then you begin to shed tears. Nobody beats you. As in, you just start crying. Do you understand? You know, I just feel that African parents, man, thumbs up. I love my mom so much because she made me the woman I am today, or the girl. Am I a woman? I don't know, but truth is, I owe her almost everything. Like, I owe her my life. Because I feel that if she hadn't brought me up in the way that she did, then I could have been a nuisance. I could have been a useless child. I could have been, you know, one of those girls who would just live a promiscuous life and wouldn't care about the repercussions of my acts. But mom, if you're watching this, I love you. And I'm so grateful for the kind of upbringing that you gave to me. I mean, at my age, I go out and it's already 5 or 6 and I'm running home like there's somebody going to flog me. That's weird, right? But then that's how I grew up, you know. And I owe everything to my mom, and I owe most of it to my dad too, because my dad would never just listen to hearsays. He wants to discuss it with my mom. He wants to be sure that beating me would be the best solution. He wants to be sure that talking to me will be the best solution. He wants to be sure that the story he was told, well, like about something I did when he was away, is actually true, you know. So I think they just make a perfect couple. Like, sometimes you feel that both of them are going to disagree on something, but then they agree and then they scold you and treat your fuck up only to disagree later. You know, it's just really weird. But I just thought I should tell you like a little bit of a little story of, you know, how I was brought up. I wasn't born into a wealthy home, but my mom never made me feel like you cannot have it if you want it. She just makes you feel like, look, if you have it, if you need to have it, then you need to work for it. I think that's why I like to work for almost everything I have. Like, I hate to depend on people. That's something that they instilled in me, that nobody can take that away from me. Nobody. I am that person that I need 5 naira. I just feel I need to work to get the 5 naira. Like, I don't believe in asking anybody for it. And if I ask you for it, it means that, man, no way, I don't try. Like, there's no way. But then, I don't even ask everybody. I ask just a few people. You know, I just ask people that I'm very sure and very comfortable asking. I can't just ask anybody. You know, so my mom makes you feel that, my mom tells you that if you need to have it, then you need to work for it. And my dad tells you that, look, for you to have it, you need to work extra hard, not just work and get it and then spend it. Because when someone gives it to you and you don't know the value of it because you didn't work for it, so you have to work for it. And I think my siblings and I, we got that, like, we're independent. And I think it's, sometimes I really think it's bad, because my friends are like, Betha, you don't even get asked people for something, what's wrong with you? Even when you know that you don't have it and this person can give it to you. But then I think it's pride. I'm proud. I'm sorry, but I'm proud. I'm too proud to beg. Like, I'll rather work and have it. Okay, I think that's about it. I was just going to tell you a little story of my upbringing so you don't get confused about my personality. I'm just a girl who was loved by both parents, you know, and those two people, my dad and my mom, they gave me the best that they could afford. Trust me, it might not be much, you know. I didn't get all the money I wanted when I was in school, but I got what I could, you know. I made do with that, and I finished school. And you know, it's just the story of a girl who's determined to just be great in life, thanks to my parents, who gave me the notion and then who gave me the ideology that you can be anything at all that you want to be, as long as you have determination, and then you have the will, and then you have the zeal, and then you pray to God. Yes. Okay, I think that's about it, people. I'll see you again in my next episode. But before I go, I need to remind you, remember, you have to subscribe. So don't forget to click on the subscribe button. And if you like what you just saw, don't forget to click the like button. Give me a thumbs up. If you have anything you want me to know about, just put it in the comment section down below. Don't forget that I love you, okay? Like, I really do care about you. Love yourself, love your neighbors, love everybody, and take good care of yourself. Like, work starts tomorrow. And I haven't even found what to wear, but who cares? I'm going to do that like right away as soon as I end this video. But I just really needed to say something up here to you guys because of the so much love I have for you people. Okay, take care of yourself. I'm just going to go back to my honey. What's this drink? I'm not a drunk. Okay, bye.